Okay, YouTube, got the power supply on. It's 6/10 with no load, and if I plug in the adapter, it's only using 1/10 of a watt by itself. And then I've got my HD Home Run. I'll plug that in. And there we get the blinking lights. There's the red power. Now, I don't have the Ethernet plugged in here, but we're using about 3.7 or 3 watts more after I plug this in. Let me see if I can round up a little longer cable here, and we'll see if the Ethernet takes any more power. Okay, I got pulled the Ethernet cable out of my printer here, and let's see if the power goes up at all with the Ethernet plugged in. And now the red light turned green. Once you plug the Ethernet in, the red LED turns green. Yeah, it's only using 3.1 watts of power running. And the other thing I want to see is, ultimately, I want to run this off of my solar battery bank. So I want to see how much actual DC current it's using. So let's switch over to my DC power supply. Okay, so there I've got a 2.1 millimeter coaxial power plug, and I've got that in my bench supply output, and let me plug that into the HD Home Run, and we'll turn on the power. It looks like right at 0.5 amp, so I'm thinking I can actually, for starters, these little wall supplies are 5 volts, 1 amp. I'm going to try running 2 HD Home Runs off of one power supply. No sense having 2 little wall warts plugged in if I can use one. And I'll just see if the wall supply gets too hot. Should be able to handle 1 amp. It's rated for 1 amp. And then if that works, I'm going to be replacing this wall supply, 120 volts. I'll replace that with a little DC step-down converter that'll put out 5 volts and 1 amp of DC power off of my solar battery bank. And in fact, my TV distribution amplifier is running the same way. I've got a little DC step-up converter for it. It needs 15 volts. I've been running that for about 3 years now, and it runs just perfectly. It hasn't gone offline since then. Runs 24 hours a day and hasn't cost a single penny since I turned it on. So okay, there I have the AC power supply plugged in. I'm going to connect the dual HD Home Runs. And it jumps up there. Looks like the power supply does use a little more power at the top end, 6.9, so 6.3 watts roughly. So it takes 6.3 watts of AC power, and we're putting out 5 watts of DC power, 5 volts at 1 amp. So this is about 80% efficient power supply. That's not too bad. Most of these supplies that I see are closer to 50% or worse. I want to be able to have my TV system independent of the power utility. So if I can get everything, I've got all my preamplifiers and distribution amps are DC powered. I'll get the HD Home Run tuner DC powered. The Ethernet switch, or all the switches, are ultimately going to be DC powered. Then the key one is getting the Synology disk station running on solar power. That'll be the big project, because that's the biggest load. But I want to do all these small ones first. They're easy. So that's kind of my strategy. I can swap those things over. 6 watts of power, take 6 watts off the utility grid, and put about 5.5 watts on my battery bank. That's very easy to do. It costs almost nothing. And if you just keep repeating, taking 6 watts off the grid, you did that 16 times, that's 100 watts. I guess the next step will be, I need to plug this guy into my network switch and then see if we can detect this and get the firmware updated. I imagine the firmware is out of date on this unit. So I'll update the firmware, and then we'll add it to the DVB link. So I'll show you that in another video here, so stay tuned. And if you have any questions about the HD Home Run, it's a pretty nice little tuner. Post up in the comment section there below the video description. And if you found that video interesting, give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more kind of look inside or tear down videos, post up in the comment section. I'll try to do more videos like that in the future. And as always, thanks for watching.